So what is the potential problem here? Well, it's really important to teach puppies manners around food. I often see puppies later on when they're fully grown dogs with impulse control problems. So that's a problem where the dog doesn't understand that they need to control those desires and urges to eat food or to get the toy. And they can result in problems later on if they're not taught food manners from an early age. So why does the problem occur? Well, puppies to start with get free fed. To start with, at the very beginning, they feed as and when they really want with their mother very, very regularly. And then when the breeder turns them to drier food, they also get fed on a really regular basis, and they don't often have to wait for their food or move back from their food bowls. In fact, they're often in competition with their littermates to get to the food first. So there are some really cool training exercises that we can do to teach our puppies not to grab hands or to snatch food out of hands or to jump up to get food. Here at School for Dogs, we use treats for training a lot. It's a primary reinforcer, which means that makes the dog feel good and it almost helps them to survive. So it's really deeply inbuilt that eating food feels good for a dog. We can use that to motivate a dog to do behaviours that we find desirable. And that's the best way to teach a dog to do something new. So better than allowing the dog to do whatever they want and then telling them off when they get it wrong, we can show them straight away that it's rewarding in every way to do something that we want them to do, and then work from there. So we do use food in training. It doesn't mean that you can never not use food in training, and hopefully a lot of these skills that we reward to start with as puppies will become just inbuilt behaviours that the puppy does because it's functionally rewarding, like sitting for a lead to go on becomes functionally rewarding because it means you get to go for your walk quicker. Also, it trains default behaviours. So it trains puppy to know that when that rug goes down, they settle on it, and they do it every time, so it becomes a built-in habit. That doesn't mean we should stop using food in training. I believe that we should use food in training for the rest of the dog's life. I mean, why wouldn't you? It makes your dog feel good. I wouldn't go to work if I didn't get paid. And we shouldn't expect our dogs just to work for us because they love us. Because we know that they're more emotionally complicated than that. And that developing a good bond happens as a result of rewarding behaviours coming to and fro. So we do use treats in training. So to teach food manners, we're going to use three little tricks. The first one is around the food bowl going down to the dog. So we're going to put some food in the food bowl and the dog is going to have to sit in order to get their food. This increases impulse control, so the dog understands that they have to be calm, sit and be away from the food before the food comes to them, and that as a result of breaking that calmness and trying to get in there, the food goes away. Secondly, we're going to teach the dog from our hand. So when our hand has got food in it here, instead of nibbling and biting and trying to get to the food, actually moving away from the food and waiting patiently results in the food coming to your mouth. And thirdly, we're going to do a little kind of lever exercise whereby we have a pile of food on the floor, and by leaving the food and moving backwards away from the food, the dog gets the food. So all these things help the dog to learn that not to come in and just grab the food at all, and teaches the dog that by default, if there's food there, they should move back and wait patiently in order to get the food. And that's a really brilliant skill for a dog to have for the rest of their life.
Size one. Firstly, put a little bit of your dog's food in her bowl and then ask her to sit. All the time she remains in a sit, the bowl slowly comes down to the floor. Every time she breaks the sit, the bowl goes back up again. Once on the floor, say okay and let her have the food. To begin with, we can release the puppy with an okay command before the food actually hits the floor. But then with each practice, hold out a little bit longer and a little bit longer until the bowl is on the floor and you're standing upright and the dog remains in a sit before you release them. You want to do this a little bit by bit because it's quite hard for the puppy to begin with. Size 2 stops your dog from becoming pushy and snatchy around food. So first have a handful of treats in your hand and present them to your puppy. Now what you're going to do, we're going to have your clicker in your other hand, and every time your puppy moves slightly away from the food, you're going to click and you're going to give them a treat. You're going to repeat this 10 times. Once your puppy's got it 10 times, I want you to wait until they physically move back from the food before you click and treat. Then, each time you repeat it, you're going to wait for the puppy to move back and wait a couple of seconds before you click and treat. If you practice this every day, then you'll begin to be able to put the food down towards your puppy and wait for him as he moves back and stays away before he gets a click and a treat. This is much better than puppies that dive into hands and try and snatch food from hands. You can even test this further by having a slight open hand. If your puppy can look and watch the hand open up, then give him a bit of the food. If when you open up, your puppy comes towards the hand, simply close the hand to show him that coming towards the hand makes the food disappear, but moving away from the hand actually gets the click and the treat. We're teaching puppies impulse control here, and we're teaching them that food in a hand doesn't mean that it's necessarily going to go straight into their mouth.
Good boy. We can see how he's beginning to get the concept now, and he's beginning to sit back and look at me as opposed to obsessing about the hand. Hands generally gets us nothing. Moving away from hands, good boy.
This Noofy puppy is really impulsive, so he goes in with teeth and paws a lot to start with. So it's important that we keep our aims for him quite low. As soon as he moves his mouth away, even when he's pawing, he gets a click and a treat. So that treats come thick and fast when his mouth is away from my hand. Then, after a couple of successions like this, I begin to wait until there's no paws or mouth until I click and treat. That way we can teach him quicker and keep the criteria low so that he stays motivated and wants to play the game.
Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. And he's just giving him a bit more food manners. Does that make sense? Good boy.
If exercise 3 is that moving away from any food means you get a reward. This will help in the kitchen if you drop food when you're cooking so that your dog sits or moves away instead of going straight in and eating something that might be dangerous. So be it on a coffee table or on a floor, you can play this game. Every time he moves away from the food that's under your hand, he gets a click and a treat. If he stays away, you can begin to open your hand up so that he can see it and he can get another click and a treat. If he goes towards the food disappears again under your hand. Treats always come from the other hand, not from the pile on the floor, as this keeps the game a bit clearer for the dog. So he moves towards it, the treat disappears. But when he moves away from it, the treat reappears and he gets a treat from my hand and a click to make it clear. When the dog gets better, we can begin playing one for me, one for you, and adding one to the pile each time the dog gets it right. When the dog gets really good at this game, we can begin dropping treats into the pile. To start with, we can do this from a sitting position, so we're not dropping too far, and all the time he doesn't go for the food, he gets a click and a treat. And then, as he gets better and better, we can begin to stand up and continue playing this game and drop it onto the floor. If he doesn't go for it, he gets a click and a treat. This is going to help your dog so much with impulse control, so that if you've got children who drop their food, or if you drop food in the kitchen, your dog asks you whether or not he can have a treat, as opposed to diving in and eating something that might potentially be dangerous on the floor. It also makes him realise that he has to ask in order to get rewards, and that he can't just take them himself.
Boy, one for you.